Hi everyone, Michael Woodhouse here on Thursday the 18th of August. Obviously it's a sitting week and normally on a Thursday I'd be anticipating heading home this evening, but as we're in urgency, passing a number of pieces of legislation, it's probably going to be tomorrow night or Saturday before I head back to Dunedin. The reason we're in urgency is because there are a number of pieces of legislation that once passed are sort of time bound. There's plenty of things that need to be done by officials in order that they become effective in early 2012. So they're mostly uncontroversial and they've almost all been to select committee, but we just need to get on past a number of pieces of legislation because this year, of course, is a short year on the legislative calendar, made even shorter actually by the fact that we lost a week after the Christchurch earthquake in February. I'm just sitting here actually watching the funeral of Sir Paul Reeves, our Governor General, in the 1980s. So a very sad occasion for the country and of course for his family following his passing this week. And this week's also been a bit of a theme for Governors General because yesterday I attended the state luncheon at Parliament to mark the end of the time of Sir Anand, Satyanand, who's our present Governor General until the end of August, when General the Right Honourable Sir Jerry Mateparae will be taking over as our Governor General. So it's been a bit of a changing of the guard in more ways than one this week. And of course, it's freezing cold as one of the largest snowstorms in generations has swept across the country. For Dunedin, it was a pretty typical sort of a winter storm, one that we'd get every couple of years or so. But for the rest of the country, in particular Christchurch, they got a real dumping. And even here in Wellington, where it was quite unusual to fly over the houses of Brooklyn and Karori on Tuesday morning and see them covered in snow. And even those poor cherubs in Auckland got a dusting of snow as well. So it's been cold. I hope it's warm where you are. And certainly the fact that the government's been investing several hundred million dollars in the Warm Up New Zealand Heat Smart program will certainly be assisting that, because more than 114,000 homes have now been insulated under that program, including nearly 5,500 in Otago. So I'm really proud of that. And I'm also proud of the fact that yesterday the Minister of Energy and Resources announced the fact that record levels of renewable electricity are now being generated in New Zealand, and our emissions from electricity generation are at their lowest level for 10 years. So we're certainly on track to reduce our reliance on fossil fuels in electricity generation. Now, last weekend was the National Party's annual conference in Wellington, the 75th anniversary of the forming of the National Party. So there was quite a good mood, of course, over the weekend, but a steely determination to not be complacent during the election campaign, which will kick off very soon. One of the big things we announced was welfare reform, particularly for our young. What we know is that there are nearly 13,000 16 and 17 year olds who have left school but aren't working, they're not in training, and really we're not sure where they are. So we're going to change that. We're going to make sure that the Education Act and the Social Welfare Acts are, and the Privacy Act rather, are amended in order that schools are able to let the Ministry of Social Development know when 16 and 17 year olds drop out of school. And we'll be providing supports for them to ensure that they are in training or part of the Youth Guarantee, the Trades Academies programs that we've set up, and in the cases of teen parents, maybe teen parenting. Because if they get to 18 and go on the unemployment benefit, as 90% of them presently do, we know that they are most likely to become long-term unemployed and disenfranchised, not only from the work ethic, but from society in general. So we're not prepared to take a hands-off approach anymore. We're going to put lots more supports in around them, including helping them with their parenting and their budgeting skills. So that's been a policy announcement that's been received really well, and I think you can expect, as the Welfare Working Group report is analysed by government, further announcements in the lead-up to the election on our proposals for welfare. So that's it from me this week. We'll catch you soon. Cheers.